contribute to anything, man. You was on the fucking bench. You didn't get in a game not one time. Didn't score not one point. Still not one ball. You ain't even sweat, nigga. You ain't sweat.
Tony Kukoc, man.
You know what I'm saying?
Bloody D-Vots, nigga.
Tony was getting down.
And Tony got down. I was a bloody D-Vot. That nigga ain't do shit. That nigga ain't do nothing.
You know what I'm saying? So it's like, hey, you know, that's what it is. But when you really putting in that work, you know, when you out there getting your fucking Curry on and KD, you know what I'm saying? Irvin, LeBron, even though I like the nigga, you know, I throw him in there. When you putting in work, man, you like, yeah, you feel it. You know what I'm saying? Instead of just saying, man, hey, y'all killed it today. You like, we killed it. We handled that. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to tell the bros, man, y'all killed it on the highways today. No, fuck that. I want to be like, hey, man, it was a beautiful day on the highways we had. You know what I'm saying? I want to put in my work too, man. All right? That was a beautiful lesson I did. You know, it, you know, a response video to the other brother said, man, that brother be killing it. You can kill it too, though. You know, it might not be the same kind of killing. You might, hey, he might kill with an axe. You might kill with a pencil. I don't know. But, you know, at the end of the day, you need breaks.
Hey, our works is going to compliment. You know what I'm saying? If we in the spirit of Yahweh Shem Yahushai, our works, no matter how big they are, as long as they towards Yahweh Shem Yahushai, they're going to compliment one another, man. And again, that makes a strong body and a well-oiled machine.
Yeah, it's just like a fucking football team, man. All right? They complement each other. Any sports, really, or any team that really have team chemistry, they're going to complement each other. Okay. But the fact that I was watching a little clip from, fuck, what's that movie? They got Joe Boone or some shit like that.
Oh, you're talking about, damn, I just thought of it in my head.
And it left.
Yeah.
They got Andre 3000 in
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah. With
I don't know, but what's his name? Paul Boone in the movie or something? Tropical something.
Tropical.
Was it a tropical something?
No idea. There's the name of the team, the Tropics.
Okay, yeah. That's it.
With Will Ferrell.
Yeah, Will Ferrell, yeah. Yeah, but basically, you know, when they did that first alley, and they didn't know what to call it, like, to do alleys and shit, you gotta have team chemistry, man. You know, because if you don't know a nigga get dunked, you just throw the ball up, he's not gonna jump up to dunk that bitch. You know, but if the other team see it, they can, you know what I'm saying, snatch. I just snatched the motherfucking alleys out there. I mean, I just jump, block the shit. But, you know, if that team chemistry ain't there, it's not going to compliment it. You're going to look sloppy as hell. I'd have been at plenty of pickup games, and that shit just looking nasty. It's like, y'all got the wrong people on teams, man. Y'all got the wrong people on teams. Hey, that time when we played all them niggas were obviously homies, you know what I'm saying? But our chemistry, in my mind, I said, okay, this is what I'm going to have to do. This is what I need him to do. This is what he going to do. It's like we all said the same thing in our head because everybody played their part. And we won twice. You know what I'm saying? We won twice.
But even if you're not a starter, even if you a practice player and you help get the team ready, yeah. You know what I'm saying? You did your part. What that is in this truth, that's somebody that's not going out on the highways. You know what I'm saying? But every week, during the week, they studying. They getting ready. You know what I'm saying? They going over lessons themselves. They writing precepts down. Getting they lessons in order. Preparing for when they do hit the highways. That's what people in this truth that's not on this side need to be doing right now. Studying, getting your game ready. Sharpening your sword. Because one day your number going to get called. When your number get caught, you want to be ready. Jimmy Garoppolo, when Tom Brady got hurt and he had to come in the game, what happened? Jimmy was ready. When Tom Brady got suspended and he thought he was going to play 4 games, Jimmy was ready. He got hurt, and then what happened? Brissett came in the game, what happened? He was ready. If you're the understudy, you need to be ready.
You need to be studied.
That's why it's called an understudy. Exactly. It's not called an underlagging. or underplaying. No. Oh, no, it's not. Verse 4, it says, but let every man prove his own work, and then he shall have rejoicing in himself alone, and not another, for every man shall bear his own burden.
For every man shall bear his own burden. I mean, you gotta go through your own shit too. You know what I'm saying? You can't just comfort other brothers with their problems. You gotta handle your problems and go through your own problems too, man. Because you gotta earn your own stripes. All right, you have to earn your own stripes, man. Like the brother said, just because you hang with warriors don't mean that you're a warrior. You know what I'm saying? You sitting around these men that go to war all the time, and they give your ass some armor and expect you to, you know, and hey, they drag you in the car with them one day. Where we going? We got to go to war. Wait, hold up. Is that what y'all gave me this armor for? I thought this was a gift. No, you rolling with us. You know what I'm saying? Hey. That's why you gotta play your part too, man. You that cheerleading type dude, and you just on, oh, kick his ass. But that's what it's telling about not doing. Right now, not being the person on the side, man, but put in your work. You know what I'm saying? Get your hands dirty. You know? You sitting here watching us dig holes and shit. You know what I'm saying? Knowing damn well we work at the graveyard. We gotta dig, you watching us. You know what I'm saying? I be hating motherfuckers that at work that's like that. You obviously ain't doing nothing at all, but you gonna sit here and watch me while all this running around and catch up with my machine and shit, instead of just helping, you know?
When you see what the prophets have suffered in the scriptures, you see the things that they went through, being faced with death, being faced with tribulation, having to deal with niggas, you know, like you should want to fight for the Lord, man. That makes you like, damn, the prophets went through this. And you see what the Most High blessed them, man. The Most High, he gave them the spirit to understand the scriptures and the spirit to keep pushing. That's what you should want, man. You should want to get your stripes set, bear your cross. Why would it say bear your cross and you on the corner, you on the sideline with pom-poms, man? You should want to get in the game and get some scrapes on your goddamn knee, man. Get a couple bruises. Yeah, get your jersey dirty, you know? Not from just rolling around on the sideline, you know?
Because you fell off the bench.
Because cheerleading don't make you no man. Being my shit escaped me, but being a sideline nigga, it don't make you no man of the Lord. You know, like the brother said, he said it beautifully, man. You have to be getting ready to go to war, man. Spiritually, and at a point where it's going to get physical. You have to be getting ready, man. Right now. Not right now, but right now.
You know, when you even come out on the highways, everybody don't start speaking. You know, some brothers holding signs, some brothers speaking, some brothers reading, some helping with precepts, some holding posts. Everybody doing their job, and then as you go on, you know, constantly do things, the spirit moves to however it moves it and put people where it needs to be at. It's just like a football team. You know, you have people that play certain positions in college, and when they come to the pros, when they get to a team, the team switch up what position that they at, you know, to better fit the team.
You know, we mentioned, you know, getting your jersey dirty, you know, putting in that work. This is a good example right here. This is Isaiah chapter 63, verse 1. Who is this that cometh from Edom with dyed garments from Basra? This that is glorious in his apparel, traveling in his greatness and strength, that I might speak in righteousness, mighty to save. Wherefore thou art red in thine apparel, and thy garments like he that treadeth the wine fat.
Yeah, because it's talking about Yahushai, man. He's the one that's coming from Basra. Alright? He's the one that's gonna get his garments dirty. Alright, from Edom, man. Like, so-called white men walk around like they ain't got nothing to pay for, man. They act like we forgot. They act like the Lord forgot. That's what it really is, man. They are blinded by their wickedness because they act like the Lord. They feel like, man, y'all know we was in fucking caves? He was wearing deteriorated drawers. You know?
Disintegrated.
That shit was fucking beast. We was eating lice. You know what I'm saying? We was fucking beasts. And look how far we came. Ever since the Renaissance shit, we've been good. We've been running the earth. That's because the Lord ain't really did nothing. But the Lord just allowing you to rough yourself up.
Alright.
He's gonna harden your heart. Alright, so he can show forth his power. That's what's happening. And you can't see it because you're blinded by your wickedness and your pride, man. Which is a good thing.
It says, I have tread in the winepress alone, and of the people there was none with me, for I will tread them in my anger, and I will trample them in my fury, and their blood shall be sprinkled upon my garments, and I will stain all my raiment.
So the Lord gonna get his hand, he gonna get his hands dirty, man. His garments dirty as well.
So why wouldn't you want to get your garments dirty? Why wouldn't you want to be there with him, fighting alongside him? But you know, you wanna be, look at your house, I'll try getting down over
get
there.
Down. Get down.
You next, nigga.
Yeah. Like Cat Williams said, you're next. Don't do it.
And not only just want to get your garments dirty because he's doing it, but knowing why you're getting your garments dirty.
Hey, the scriptures say, cursed be he that keepeth his sword from blood, man.
Okay.
That's what the scriptures say, man.
All right.
Cursed be he that keepeth his sword from blood. All right. And what is known as a sword? The Bible. All right. So cursed be you if you ain't on the highways defending this gospel. Yeah. In that sense, too, man.
Yeah.
You got to put in that work. You have to put in work.
Butter.
You know?
Yeah.
Butter knife.
Butter on toast, man. Read
the scriptures. Yeah.
God. This is back in 1 Corinthians chapter 2. And in verse 10, it says, but the Most High have revealed them unto us by his Spirit, but the Spirit searcheth all things, yea, the deep things of the Most High. For what man knoweth the things of a man, save the spirit of man which is in him?
Yeah, you know how somebody operates by the spirit that's within that person, man. Edomites, you know them fuckers is proud. All right, Jake, you know them motherfuckers slick, they're crafty. They some lying motherfuckers too. You know what I'm saying? You know people by the spirit. Hey, and just like you gotta try the spirit by the spirit, man. People come up here and they might look like other nations. You just bring out scriptures. Alright, and then you figure out what their nationality is, you know, 95% of the time I would say, based on how they react, man. Alright? By the spirit that's within that man. Okay, you dealing with a woman, alright? You know this bitch is crazy. You know what I'm saying? And she at times she cool, and at times she crazy. That's the spirit that she had. So when she come with that, oh, let's be cool shit, you gotta go, nah, man. We tried that too many times. It just ain't working out. You know what I'm saying? That's the spirit. That's how you know a person, man, by the spirit that's within them. Alright? It's not like you can go buy a different spirit every day. This is the spirit that the Lord gave you.
Says, even so, the things of the Most High know of no man, but the Spirit of the Most High.
Yeah, so you can't know the things of the Most High unless he give you that spirit to know of him, man. All right, to understand, all right? Go ahead.
Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit which is of the Most High, that we might know the things that are freely given to us of the Most High.
Yeah, because if you got the spirit of the world, you can't receive the things of the Most High. Okay? You're gonna be in that natural state. You're gonna be thinking carnal, man. So when you like, oh shit, who was that, Peter? Simon Peter, oh. Hey, we can eat pork now based on his vision. No, it don't work like that. Why would the Lord tell you not to eat pork? Say that I changed not. Tell you he came not to destroy the laws and the prophets and then say you can eat pork. That's non-consistent at, like, the Lord don't roll like that. That's too confusing. You know? That's too confusing for him to just go like that, man. right at the end of it, hey, you can eat pork now, check me out. No, fuck that.
Come on, it's funny, honey. Yeah. Like the Most High desperate for a follower or something.
Yeah.
like he thirsty for followers.
He said, I can raise up stones to serve me. And when I think of that, now I think about that Power Ranger movie. I mean, they had to fight against the rocks. They was just practicing shit. Y'all remember that part? He said he can raise up stones, man. You know what I'm saying? Therefore, with the Lord saying that he's content with stones serving him, then you better get and keep your act together.
Jesus.
Tied together open.
These clothes motherfucker ain't there.
Yeah. They got their heat on. Hi. Yeah.
It says, verse 13, which things also we speak, not in the words which man wisdom teacheth, but which the Holy Spirit teacheth, comparing spiritual things with spiritual.
Comparing spiritual.